Visual Studio Code is absolutely amazing, and the plugin ecosystem around it even more. There are hundreds of fantastic extensions available that can significantly improve your coding workflow. In this video, I will show you 7 CSS-related extensions that you should start using immediately. All right, first up, we have an extension called CSS Peek, and this is a very popular extension with over 3.5 million downloads or installs. And this extension allows you to peek into CSS definitions from HTML files. I'm gonna show you how it works right away. So let's jump to HTML. You can peek into CSS files from HTML with the command palette. So I'm gonna open it right now, and I'm gonna search for peek command, and I have here peek definition. And if I open it in this pop-up window, you're gonna see exactly CSS related to the class I have selected in my HTML. So here we have class test with the color Rebecca purple, for example. You can also use keyboard shortcut to peek into definition. And if you open a command palette, you're gonna see the keyboard shortcut right here, which is in my case, option F12. So I'm gonna use option F12 now, and I'm gonna see exactly the same result. Let me close this. And this extension doesn't work only with classes, but also with IDs and even with tag names. So for example, if I wanna see where is my body defined in CSS, I can again peek with Alt F12. And here I'm gonna see a list of all files where the tag body is defined. And I have quite a lot of those right here. So I can jump quickly between those and see exactly what is in my CSS. Or if I want to just really quickly jump between those files immediately without just peeking into them, I can use F12 shortcut. Let me try this. So if I just use F12, I'm gonna jump between all of those files where this class or this ID or the stack in this particular case is defined. And one thing to mention about CSS Peek is that tag support is not immediately enabled. So if you jump into settings, and I'm gonna jump into settings right here under extension and CSS Peek, you can see exactly all the options available for CSS Peek. You can define which languages you wanna peek from, you can define which folders to exclude, and you can enable support for tags right here if you don't have this already enabled. It's a really handy extension, and I really recommend you install it if you're not one among the 3 million that already have it installed. Next up, we have HTML CSS support, and this is effectively CSS IntelliSense for HTML, which allows you to autocomplete classes and IDs from your HTML. So I'm gonna jump again into my HTML example here. The first thing to note here is that this extension automatically picks up linked style sheets from your HTML. So if you have a link element with the href that points to CSS file, this extension will then offer you all the classes and IDs from this respective file in your HTML. So if we try this right here, we have this class here, and if I want to autocomplete it, I can use control space, and this will show me all available classes from my linked style sheet. Apart from directly linked style sheets, this extension also offers you a way to define which style sheets you want to use for autocompletion. I'm gonna jump into my extension docs again, and here somewhere at the bottom, you can see exactly how to define from which files you want to use autocomplete, and you should add this into your settings.json. So let me switch to my options here and options JSON, and you see here that I already have this set up. I have css.stylesheets with the number of paths that I want to use for auto completion. So if you don't have directly linked style sheets from your HTML, this is the way to define from which files you want this extension to pick up your autocomplete options. It's a fantastic extension, and I recommend you install it and try it out. Next, we have HTML to CSS autocompletion, which is actually opposite from what we just shown, which means that this will allow you to autocomplete classes from HTML. So if you define some classes in your HTML, you can autocomplete them in CSS files. So I'm gonna jump into my HTML file again, and I'm gonna add a dummy class here. And if I jump into my CSS here, if I trigger autocompletion here with the command space, I'm gonna see exactly all the classes and IDs that are defined in my CSS files. And if I search for a dummy, for example, you're gonna see that this is picked up immediately. And if I trigger show more option with the control space, I can see exactly in which file this class is actually used. So this would be in this particular case where we defined it. Another thing to note here is that you don't actually need to trigger it manually with the command space. You can just start typing and it's gonna immediately pick up all the related classes. This extension again has a number of options. So if we jump into command palette and search for auto completion, you're gonna see that here are the extension options. You can toggle trigger keys, set auto completion workspaces, and so on. So you can configure it exactly as you want. Next extension is CSS IntelliSense, and this does exactly what it says. It offers advanced autocompletion for CSS features. So I'm gonna jump into a CSS file here, and as you can see, I have 2 variables defined here, so I can trigger autocompletion of those variables if I just run the dollar sign, and as you can see, I have base color and font size immediately offered, and I can learn more about those options if I trigger the show more option from here using the command space or with a click. And here I immediately see the value of those particular variables, so I can use them. And this will of course be available in other files as well. So if I jump into another SCSS file, and for example, I want to replace this color with the variable, I can trigger auto completion again. And here I'm going to see exactly which variables are available along with the preview of the particular color, as you can see here, or with the additional information if I have the show more toggle opened. Another nice feature of this extension is that if you hover on a particular sass variable, for example, you're going to see definition for that variable and where is this variable actually coming from. And this extension, of course, should work with a number of SCSS features like variables and functions and mixins and so on. And you can see exactly how it works here in the documentation. There's a number of settings, again, available for this particular extension. You can see those settings here. So you can adjust this extension exactly to your liking. If you're working with SAS or SCSS syntax for SAS, then this is the extension that you should probably be using. Another extension that you should be using, even if you're not working with CSS, is Prettier. And Prettier is an opinionated code formatter, works with a number of languages, not just CSS. And I strongly suggest to use it because you're not going to have to think about formatting your code. Prettier is going to do all of that for you. So I'm going to jump to my CSS file here and I'm going to misformat this file, maybe like this. And now I can invoke the command palette. I can use the format document option to immediately trigger Prettier and format that particular file according to conventions set in Prettier. And there's a number of options to configure in Prettier to format code exactly to your liking. And you can find those options in the documentation again, right here under the Prettier settings. And as you can see, there's a number of settings here. And I go deep into those settings in my course, Mastering Prettier and StyleLint, which are two extensions that I strongly recommend you start using. And StyleLint is going to be the next extension that we're going to look into. One thing that you absolutely want to do when you're using Prettier is you want to set it up as your default formatter. And I'm going to jump into settings here and I'm going to search for format. And you can see here default formatter option. You want to set this to Prettier code formatter and you want to enable option format on save. That way, whenever you save a file, the entire file will be automatically formatted. You don't have to think about invoking it with the command palette or anything like that. For example, if I misformat this file again and just hit save, command S, this file will automatically be formatted according to Prettier rules. So you don't have to think about it at all. You can be certain that your files will always be perfectly formatted. And as I mentioned, there's a number of options that you can tweak. There's a number of ways you can set Prettier up, not just in Visual Studio Code, but also in package.json for your entire project, even for your entire organization, along with the continuous integration and so on. So check out my course, Mastering Prettier and StyleLint, if you want to learn more about that. The next extension that you absolutely want to be using when you're working with CSS is StyleLint. And this is essentially a linter for CSS. It does amazing things. It will not only help you avoid errors, but it will also help you enforce coding conventions. The first thing that you need to know about StyleLint is you will need to configure it to actually start using it. And you can find exactly how to configure it in the Getting Started guide on their official documentation site. You can find the link in the usage section of the extension right here. I would recommend that you install it and add it to your project using the npm, and then you can extend one of the default configurations like StyleLint config standard or StyleLint config recommended, and then you can start using it. Showing you exactly how to configure it and what are the configuration options is a little bit out of scope for this video, but again, I have a course exactly on the subject, Mastering Prettier and StyleLint, so check it out. Link is in the description, as I already mentioned. And for this particular video, I already have a configuration prepared so I can show you how it works. I'm just basically extending the recommended configuration that I installed with the npm. So once you configure it, you can start using it. And for this, I'm going to jump into my CSS file again, and I'm going to open problems view with my command palette. And in this problems window, you will see errors in your CSS that StyleLint finds. And right now it doesn't appear like I have any errors here, but if I break something, for example, let's break this color, you're going to see immediately that a number of errors pop up, and you see here that this is a StyleLint error, and this is again the same error, and this is actually coming from the default validator of VS Code. So when you install StyleLint, you will actually want to disable this default validator because there's quite a lot of overlap between those two, but I still recommend you use StyleLint because StyleLint is much more powerful than VS Code's default validator. So let's jump into settings now, and we're going to open the JSON view. You can find CSS validate option and set it to false. And if you're using SAS or less, you can disable validators for those particular languages as well immediately, because you want StyleLint to handle the linting process and not the default VS Code validators. And if I jump back to my CSS and I see exactly here that there's a problem with my CSS, this is not a valid hex color, so I can fix this error. And once I do, the error will no longer be visible in my problems console. Another thing that I want to show you here is that StyleNet can actually automatically fix a number of problems in your style sheets. For example, if I duplicate this color declaration right here, you're going to see that I have this error in StyleNet. And now if I invoke my command palette, I can run the command StyleNet fix all auto fixable problems. And this will, as you can see, immediately remove duplicate property that is unnecessary here. StyleNet is really a fantastic extension. It's very powerful. It doesn't only help you fix problems in your CSS, it can also help you enforce conventions, which is incredibly handy, again, if you're working in a theme environment. And the last extension that I want to show you is Color Highlight. And this extension essentially shows you immediately a preview of your colors in VS Studio Code. So if I jump into CSS here before I actually enable it, you're going to see that next to my colors, I have this small little rectangle that shows me a preview of the color. And I personally don't particularly like those previews because, number one, they're very small and it's very difficult to understand what is exactly the shade of the color, particularly if you're using multiple shades and you're going to have pretty much hard time understanding which one you're using here. And the second thing, this preview is actually inserted into code after you start typing, which means that your code is going to be jumping left and right when you're working on it. So for example, if I remove this color here, you're going to see that the preview disappears. And now if I return it, it takes a little bit of time before it actually appears. And when it does, my entire line is moved slightly to the right, which is not really ideal, not what I want to see. I find this quite a bit distracting. So this extension will actually show you a color highlight a little bit differently, and I'm going to enable it now. And if I jump back to my CSS, you're going to see that I see the preview of my colors over the entirety of their declarations, and I can visually see the actual shade of the color. And since, as I mentioned, those rectangles are very distracting, you can actually disable them in VS Code settings. So I'm going to open settings now, and you're going to find this option under color decorators. So if you disable this, those decorators that are available by default in Visual Studio Code will no longer work, which means that only this extension will show you the preview of the color. For my particular taste, this is much better and much nicer experience than the actual default option of showing the colors in Visual Studio Code. So those are the 7 extensions that I absolutely recommend you install if you're working with CSS. I hope you found this video helpful. I hope you found at least one extension that you didn't know about that will help you be more productive developer when you're working with CSS. And to make sure you don't miss my future videos about Visual Studio Code, hit that subscribe button. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Nyambor. I will see and hear you in the next CSS extension, right in the next video.